If you have been around for a while, you know that RouterOS can host SMB shares. Those could be on the device's built-in flash memory, or preferably you'd put them on some storage expansion like a USB stick, a memory card, or more recently even M.2 SSD drives have become an option in some models. Now, the SMB client, however, is a new addition introduced by the RouterOS package. The SMB server functionality remains accessible without installing any packages, but there have been improvements. RouterOS now supports the latest SMB version, SMB 3.1.1. Support for the old and now deprecated SMB 1 has been removed. The oldest version you can now use to connect to RouterOS is SMB 2.1, which still does not take advantage of end-to-end encryption. If you'd like to make sure that only the versions that support encryption are used, there is a new share attribute that will force the use of encryption. With that enabled, you will allow only the use of SMB 3.0 and SMB 3.1.1 when connecting to your device. The new SMB server also offers greater control over who can access what shares. First of all, the allow guest attribute has been removed, and the server simply has a default guest user pre-configured in the IP SMB users section. The guest can be completely disabled there for the whole system. Furthermore, when setting up a Samba share, there are now two additional attributes, valid users and invalid users, where you can explicitly configure who can and cannot access this share. By default, if these fields are left empty, all users will be considered valid. When you want most users to have access to a share except one or two, just add them to invalid users. Similarly, when you want only one or two to have access, add them to the valid users and leave the invalid users field empty. Okay, let's set up a Samba share on this CCR2116. It has an NVMe SSD installed, and I will use the whole drive. But of course, you could use a subfolder of your drive as well. I want to limit access to my share to only myself, so first I want to add a user with a secure password. Then we can add our share. Pick your directory from the dropdown or type the name. Select the read-only or require encryption properties if you require them, and then you can set up specific user access. After clicking OK, your share is added and the SMB server should have started automatically if your SMB enable property is set to auto. Of course, you could have done the same setup from the CLI. It would have looked something like this. With our server running, we can now make use of the new RouterOS SMB client functionality and set it up on this RB5009. Right now, it does not have any additional storage locations available. Let's change that with a single CLI command. Add type SMB, slot is the name that will be displayed on this router, and then follow up with the usual SMB properties, IP, share, user, and password. That sets up our access to the SSD drive, and the new storage location shows up in our file list. Now this RB5009 can read and write files to that location, almost like it was its own drive. That concludes the setup, but remember, the RouterOS package is only needed for the client part. The SMB server is available in the base package on all RouterOS devices, with the only exception being the SMIPS architecture. Will you make use of SMB in your MikroTik devices, or perhaps you're already making use of it? Let us know in the comments what you use SMB for.